Welcome to this video lecture on design of commutator and brushes from third unit design of DC machines in the subject design of electrical apparatus. So different types of commutation in DC machines includes resistance commutation, retarded commutation, accelerated commutation and sinusoidal commutation. So in the design aspect, so this is the construction view of commutator and brushes. So this is actually commutator. In between, this line represents insulation and this is commutator segment. Each commutator segments are separated with the insulation. Okay, so commutator segments and this is length of the commutator that we are going to calculate, and then this is the brush. So brush is having the dimensions. So this is thickness of the brush, length of the brush, and this is width of the brush. And suppose if you assume this is the direction of rotation of the commutator. Commutator is the rotating part of the machine. Brush is the fixed part of the machine. So while the commutator is rotating anti-clockwise direction in this picture, so this is the entering edge for the brush. So at this edge of the brush, the commutator will enter, and from through this edge, the commutator will leave. So this edge is represented as entering edge, and this edge is represented as leading edge. And these are all the dimensions with respect to commutator and brush we are going to calculate. So the design formulas includes the total number of commutator segments first. So these are all the commutator segments. And that commutator segments will always be equal to number of coils in the machine. So number of coils, this is the equation to find out the number of coils. That is 1 by 2 U into SA. U is the coil sides per slot and SA is the armature slots per pole. Okay, so this armature, number of armature slots already we have calculated in the previous sections. And U is the coil sides per slot. So that also known to us. And so the number of coils we will be calculating, and that is equal to the number of commutator segments. So minimum number of commutator segments must be EP by 15, because actually many number of commutator segment is advisable, so that the voltage between adjacent commutator segment will be lesser if more number of commutator segments is there. But there is a limitation in minimum number, therefore minimum number of commutator segment must be there. So if there is no minimum number is maintained, so the adjacent commutator segment, that is voltage between adjacent commutator segment will be increased much, so that the amount of spark produced will be more, so that to avoid or to improve the commutation process, that is to improve the process of sparkless commutation, minimum number of commutator segments has to be maintained as EP by 15. Okay, and E is the EMF and P is the number of poles. This is based upon, this equation usually derived based upon the peripheral velocity of the armature, that is 15 meters per second to 30 meters per second. Based on that, this equation is already derived. And then commutator segment pitch, always pitch is pi d by that particular parameter. Pi d by p is pole pitch, pi d by s is slot pitch, and commutator segment pitch is pi d by commutator segments. So commutator segment is always equal to number of coils. So c is the commutator segment, or it is also number of coils. So pi dc is the diameter of the commutator. Okay, so dc is the diameter of the commutator, and that will be 60 to 80% of the diameter of the armature. Diameter of the armature is the main dimension, D of the armature. So D is known to us. So 60 to 80% of armature diameter is considered as diameter of the commutator. So this DC is known to us, number of coils is known to us, so that you can calculate the commutator segment pitch. And that commutator segment pitch should be greater than or equal to 4 mm. So that is our final objective in the design of the commutator. Okay, so finally we will be after calculating all these parameters, we will be calculating the commutator segment pitch, and that should not exceed, so that should be greater than or equal to 4 mm. If it is not satisfied, then we will be changing the design procedures, and finally we'll be calculating this PC again. Okay, so then brush design we have to discuss. So wherein we have to calculate the width of the brush. Okay, based upon the thickness of the brush and the number of brushes. Thickness of brush we'll be calculating based upon the commutator segment pitch beta c. So that current carried by each brush, we know that is 2 times of IA by A. That is the general equation to calculate the current carried by each brush. Okay, brush current. That is 2 times of IA by A. A is equal to P for lap winding and A is equal to 2 for wave winding. So on substituting 2 here, this 2 and 2 get cancelled. So simply IA. So this is for the calculation of brush current in lap winding machine and wave winding machine. So total brush contact area per spindle is area per spindle AB, capital letter, uppercase letter AB. So that is brush current divided by current density. So this brush current, just now we have calculated by knowing the armature current. Current density will be assumed, current density will be usually assumed so that we can calculate the area of the brush per spindle, that is brush contact area per spindle. And the thing is, the area of each individual brush should be chosen such that it does not carry more than 70 amperes. So number of brushes you have to, the number of brushes in the spindle can be selected such that each brush does not carry more than 70 amperes. This is the criteria. Based on that, we will be selecting the number of brushes. So, number of brushes we are selecting based upon this criteria. So, contact area of brush in a spindle, this AB, is also equal to total number of brushes and contact area of each brush. So, this is the total contact area of brush in a particular spindle, can be into AB. So, total number of brushes we are calculating based upon current carried by each brush. So now this AB can be calculated from this equation. Also this area of contact area of each brush based upon the dimension, it is thickness and width. Okay, so it is WB into TB is the area of the contact area of the brush. Okay, so we are substituting in this equation, AB is equal to small case letter AB is equal to WB into TB. So from that we can calculate the width of the brush. Thickness of the brush is 1, 2, 3 of this commutator segment pitch. Already we know to calculate this commutator segment pitch pi DC by C, so that we can calculate thickness of the brush. So on substituting number of brush and thickness of brush, and AB already we have calculated by knowing the current and current density. So this AB is known, so that we can calculate the thickness of the brushes. So once the thickness of the brush is calculated, see here, this WB, width of the brush. Okay, WB is the width of the brush and the thickness, this is the thickness of the brush. So this thickness and width is the contact area of the brush. Okay, this is the thickness of the brush and this is the width of the brush. That too is the contact area of the brush. So that we have calculated. So the dimensions of the brush includes thickness of the brush and width of the brush and area of cross section of the brush. So contact area of each brush is WB into TB, that is width and thickness of the brush, and the total contact area of the brush in a particular spindle is number of brushes multiplied with the AB. So AB can be calculated by substituting this A, small case letter AB as WB into TB. So from this we are calculating the width of the brush. So finally we have calculated the width and thickness of the brush. Thickness of the brush will be calculated based upon this current criteria. Number of brush will be calculated based upon this current criteria. So NB is known, width of the brush is also known. And three clearances is included to calculate the length of the commutator. And finally, the length of the commutator will be calculated. And this is the formula to calculate the length of the commutator, LC. So that is NB is the number of brushes, width of the brush is WB. Plus CB is the clearance between the brushes. That value is given, 5 mm. And C1 is the clearance allowed for staggering the brushes. That value is 10 mm. It is given for a small machine, and 30 mm for a large machine. It is given. And C2 is the clearance for allowing end play. So that value is 10 to 25 mm. So this all these clearances values are known to us. We are calculating the number of brush with the current criteria and thickness of the brush. Width of the brush we are calculating after calculating the thickness of brush with this particular criteria, we will be knowing the width of the brush. So then we can calculate the length of the commutator. So in this, based upon the above calculations, we will be so this is one of the design procedures. So we have calculated the commutator segment pitch and width of the brush, thickness of the brush, number of brushes, everything we are calculating, and finally we will be calculating the brush friction loss. So this is the formula to calculate the brush friction loss. BF means brush friction loss. So this is the equation to calculate it. So this is brush, PB is the brush contact pressure on the commutator. Because commutator is a rotating part, brush is the stationary part. While the commutator is in rotation, that will make a contact with the brush. So that induces this brush friction loss. So this is the equation to calculate the brush friction loss. So brush contact pressure value is given for different type of the material of the brush. And AB is the total contact area of all brush. Just now we have calculated AB is equal to P times of AB for a lap winding, 2 times of AB for a, because the general formula is A into AB. A is the number of parallel path, it is P in lap winding and it is 2 in wave winding. So this AB is the total contact area of all the brushes. So that is AB, just now we have calculated in the previous section. So we can calculate the total AB value, we can calculate. And VC is the peripheral speed of the commutator in meter square, and this is the mu is the coefficient of tension. So all values are listed in this for different types of materials. So these unknown values we can substitute, and finally we will be calculating the brush friction loss for the particular material of this brush. So this is about the design procedure of commutator and brushes in the DC machine. Thank you for watching.